So now we are going to learn some of the basic shortcuts. So we have shortcuts. We have seen a few shortcuts like Control C, Control V, Control X. So those were the very basic shortcuts which we have used and which we use on a day-to-day basis. Now there are many number of shortcuts in Excel. So first of all, we'll start in this particular video. We'll do all the Control plus A, Control plus B, Control plus C. Basically, Control plus A to Control Z shortcuts, all these A to Z shortcuts. So there are A to Z shortcuts. There are no shortcuts available for Control J, Control M and Control Q. Instead of that, rest of all the letters have all these different shortcuts. So basically there are 23 shortcuts which you can use with the Control button. So we'll start with the very first. We have the first one as Control A, which is select all. So basically we know this, when we are in a particular table and we click on Control A, then that entire table gets selected. Or when we are somewhere outside of the table, and suppose anywhere else, when we are outside of the table and we click on Control A, then it selects the entire sheet. So this is how you work out with the Control A, which is the select all shortcut, which depends on where you place the cursor and click on the Control A button. The next we have the Control B, which is the bold. This makes your cell, whatever is written in your cell, into bold. Suppose I go to this particular cell and I click on Control B, then this changes my cell to the bold. Or you can obviously again make it normal by again clicking on Control B. So this is how Control B, and you can see this bold is being getting selected. So Control B and Control B. So this is how you work out with the Control B shortcut. The next we have very common is the Control C, which is the copy. So you can just simply, if I want to copy the cell, so I'll just click on Control C. So what happens, the cell gets copied. These are the, you can say, the dancing hands which we have over here. So if you want to know that is so if you want to know that whether your cell has been copied or not, you can just click on this arrow. You can see over here, this gives the clipboard basically. And so we have this clipboard. In the clipboard section, we have this day over here which I have copied. So again, I'll just click on the escape key. Again, I'll show you all, if I copy this Monday, Control C, and I click on this arrow over here, I have copied Monday. So this is how you, basically it gets copied to the clipboard temporarily, and when you paste it, it gets removed from the clipboard. So this is how it works. I'll click on the escape button. Next we have something as fill down. Control D. Control D gives the fill down. Now what is the fill down option? I remember we have done this. We have something called the custom list. I'll show you all again where the custom list is. We'll just go to the file options, and in this options we have so we have files and options, and in the advanced options we have, when you just scroll down, you have something called create lists for use in shorts and fill sequences. So if you all remember when we did sorting and filtering, that time we had something called the custom list. So it's exactly the same. This is used for fill sequences. What do I mean by fill sequences? I'll just explain now. And sorting. So I'll just click on this, and we have all these custom lists over here. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, January, February, and so on. So basically what will happen, what is the main aim to show you all this, is that if I write January over here and I want January 10 times maybe, if I drag, this is the fill handle I was talking about. So two places where you can use the custom list is in the sorting and filtering, basically sorting, and in the fill handle. So whenever I just fill this down, then what happens, it basically, what it does is that you can see it gives me January, February, March, April, because this is what the custom list says. But I want January for all these cells, in all these cells. So what I do is I'll select all these cells and I click on Control D. So now when I click on Control D, all these cells got selected and it gave me January. So this is how you use the fill down option. The next we have the flash fill. So I am currently using 2010 version. So I do not have this flash fill option because it came after 2013. So you all can also use it if you have your versions above, if you have your versions 2013 or above that. I'll just suppose I have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday written over here, and I just want the first three letters. First three letters, that is MONTUEWED, like that. So what I do is I'll just write Monday over here, MON, and then what I do is I select all these cells and I click on Control E. So when you click on Control E, you get all these options filled up with MONTUEWED and so on. So this is how it works. You just need to write for one cell and you just need to select all the cells and click on Control D. It's not happening for my case because I am currently using 2010 version. If you have above version, it'll be done for you. Or what you can do is if you want the last three letters, which is day for all. So then what you do, you write day over here. And then what you do, you again select this and click on Control D, then it gets filled up. But you'll see that you'll get an error. Basically, it's not an error. You'll not get the last three letters. You'll get maybe SDAY, or for this you get ESDAY. So this is how it might. This is how it might turn out for you all. Then what do you do is that you write day in the second one as well. So I've written day for the first cell, day for the second cell. So now you are telling Excel that basically what do you want is the last three letters only. So this gives a confirmation to Excel that you want the last three letters only. Then when you select all these cells and click on Control E, it will flash fill all of these cells at one go and give you the last three letters. So this is how you can work out with the flash fill option, which is Control E. You all must try this because I am currently using 2010, so it's not available for me. It's for 2013 and the above versions. Then we have the Control F, which is the find. So basically, if I click on Control F, I get this find dialog box, find and replace dialog box. So if you need to find any word or any letter, then you can simply find, suppose you can just type, suppose I need to find Monday, like, then I can just simply write Monday over here and click on find all. So it gives me all the options together wherever I have used Monday in my entire workbook. So I have used it twice in my workbook. Once I have used it here in cell E6 and once I have used it in cell E34, which is downwards. So this is how, or you can just simply Control F, and if you write Monday and you click on find next, then you just simply get all the Mondays together. So this is another in cell E34, another Monday I've written over here. So this is how it works, Control F, which is the find. Next you have the go to, Control G, and you get this go to dialog box. Basically this means that you can type any cell reference you want to go to. It can be or the named range, the named cell range you have in your workbook. So in your worksheet basically. So this is the days named range, which I have renamed these cells as days. So you can, when you click on this days and click on OK, see all these got selected. So I have basically renamed these as days. Or what I can do is Control G. Or you can simply write a cell reference over here. I can just write, let's suppose AA12. I'll write AA12 and click on OK. So it takes me to AA12. So this is how you use the go to function, Control G for the go to dialog box. Shortcut for the go to dialog box. Then where you can go to the particular named range, or you can go to a selected cell you want to go to in your worksheet. Then we have the Control H, which is the replace. So Control H, and you get this replace, find and replace dialog box. But now you get the replace option clicked on. When you click on Control F, you get the find, and when you click on Control H, you get the replace. So now here, if you want to replace, let's say suppose I want to replace, let's make this January or this Monday. Let us make this Monday as something else. So Monday, I'll make this as first day. So first day. So what I'm doing is I'm finding what? I'm finding Monday and I'm replacing it with the first day. So I'll just click on the replace. I'll just write Monday again over here and check whether it works out. Or I can just select this cell as well if I want to. Yeah. See, this is how you replace your Monday. Just because I had basically I had two Mondays. One is over here and one when you scroll down, one is over here. So both of this got changed. Or what I could have done is that if I want to again replace this, so I'll just type first day and I want to replace it with Monday. So I'll just click on find next. So it finds me the first day and it replaces this. And then again, see. So this is how both my first day got replaced over here in first table. And over here in the second table, both of these got replaced by Monday again. So this is how you use the shortcut key Control H, which is the replace. Then we have Control Italics, which is Control I. So you want, just like the bold, just see over here what will happen and click on Control I, and this automatically changes to italics. Again, when you click on Control I, it automatically changes back to normal. So this is how you use the Control I. The next we have Insert Hyperlink. So we don't have any shortcut for Control J. The next we have the K, which is the insert hyperlink. Control K gives me the insert hyperlink. So you can insert hyperlink in any cell you want to. Control K, and this gives you the insert hyperlink, which is there in the insert tab. It gives me, it opens the insert hyperlink dialog box, and you can insert your hyperlink wherever you want to. So if you want to maybe get it from a web address, so you just type in, maybe I'll write HTTP, maybe www.facebook.com, and okay, so it gives me www.facebook.com, and when I click on this particular link, it opens the, in your default browser. So my default browser, I have set it as Google Chrome. So it will open your link in that particular default browser you have. So that is your insert hyperlink. And then we have the insert table Control L. So basically this is a table, and now just let us exactly not a table in terms of Excel. Yes, it is taken as a table, but then in a table you get many options, many design options to change your table. So what I can do, when you want to insert a particular table, what do? You use the shortcut key as Control L, or you go to the insert tab and insert the table. So anywhere you take your cursor, anywhere inside the table, and click on Control L, and so it will ask you, so where is the data for your rings? Is this the data? Okay, and you click the headers are true. Okay, so it will give you headers. Basically my table has headers, so this will give you the headers option. I'll click on the okay, and see, these are the filters which I have got over here. And when I'm inside my table, this is the design table tools which I have opened up. So this gives me the idea, okay, that this is a table which I have formed using Control L. Now what do you do is you can change, you can format your table any way you want to. And again, when you want to convert it back from a table to a normal range, you just click on over here, which is convert to range. And then, do you want to convert the table to a normal range? Yes, and your table gets converted back to a normal range. So this is how you work out with the Control L option. The next option which we have over here is the Control M, which is nothing. So we have no shortcut for Control M. Then we have Control N, which is, it opens a new workbook. So if I click on Control N, so it opens a new workbook. See, book 1, which is entirely new workbook which I have over here. You can close the workbook using Control W shortcut. So for the timing, I'll just minimize this to show you all the next shortcut we have in our class. Then we have, so Control N gives you a new workbook, Control O opens a new workbook, opens a workbook basically. So, and what it does is, it you can open an existing workbook. So I'll just click on Control O, and you get this dialog box, which you get when you go to the file option as well. So from here you can select any of these, and you can simply select any of these to open. Click on any of these, and when you click on the OK button, it opens the new existing workbook. So Control N gives you a new workbook, Control O opens up a existing workbook from your desktop, wherever you have saved it. You can just navigate through and open it. Then we have the Control P. So it basically, what it does is that it opens up the print review option. So when you click on the Control P, it opens the print review option over here, which you can see over here, and you can do all your editing options from here, change the margins, change the scaling, and all those stuffs which you can do this over here. So this we have done. Then we move on to the next, which is Control P was the print. Control Q, for Control Q we have no shortcut keys. For Control R it is filled right. So like Control D, it was like exactly like Control D, which was filled down. We have something called Control R, which is filled right. So what do I do is, when I select all these, and just if I want January in my corresponding cells as well, or basically in this particular column, I select this column and I click on Control R. So when I click on Control R, you basically fill right. Similarly to fill down, which fills it downwards, this fills rightwards. So see, Control R and it fills rightwards. Control R and it fills rightwards. So this is the shortcut key for Control R is the shortcut key for the fill right. Then we have the save option, very much used, Control S. So if you are saving, see, nothing happened, just when you see the taskbar over here, Control S, it will save, it will give you a quick status over here that it is saving your workbook. So basically this is a pre-saved workbook, which I am just changing, making a few changes to this workbook, and when you click on Control S, it will save your workbook. But when you want to save as your workbook, when you have a new workbook basically, and you click on Control S, then it will ask you where you want to save your workbook. So this is the save as option which you get when you click on Control S. This happens when you are saving a new workbook. So you can just give the location, you can just select the location from here, and you can rename it and whatever you want to, and you can just save it simply. So there are two options. Control S gives you a save option, basically it saves your workbook when you are updating or making any changes to your existing workbook, or it opens the save as dialog box if you are saving a new workbook. Right, then we have the insert table, Control T. So it's exactly similar to Control L, which we have done above. Control L was also the insert table option, and similarly we have Control T, which is also insert table option. So we have two shortcut keys for control for adding a table, inserting a table. Why this is so? Because of the versions, earlier version had Control L. So for the it's basically the all versions now have Control N, Control T as the insert table shortcut. So now when you click on OK, it inserts a table over here. So you can just simply change the features wherever you want to, anything like that. And then again, you want to convert it to a range, you can just simply go to the design. Okay, so when you are outside the table, this thing is gone, this new tab is gone. When you are inside the table, this design option is there, and you can just click on the convert to range and convert the table back to a normal range. Then we have something as Control U, which is underline, shortcut key for underline. So Control U, see, this underline got selected and Wednesday has been underlined. Control U and it again goes back to the normal. So after U we have Control V, which is paste, which we have used many a number of times. So when I click on Control C, so this has been copied. I'll just click on this clipboard over here, and you can see Wednesday has been copied, and you can just, wherever you want to, you can just go and Control V and you can paste the same over here. And if you want to paste it like a value, you can have this option over here as a function, or you want to just paste the formulas, or you want to paste just the formatting. So this is how you copy paste in Excel. Now I'll click on escape to remove this thing over here. Then we have, after Control V, we have Control W, which I was talking about is the close workbook option. So if I have this new workbook and I click on Control W, it will simply close the workbook. So I didn't make any changes. So it simply shuts down the workbook without asking me, without giving me any pop-up. But when I try to close this workbook, I'll click on Control W. It will ask me whether you want to save the changes you have made or not. So this is because I have made certain changes to this. And before saving, when you close the workbook, it will give you, it gives you a dialog box. Then we have the cut option, which is Control X. So it's simply Control X. When you click on the Control X, it basically sends it to the clipboard. So you have Wednesday again, you have two Wednesdays here. So again, you have this Wednesday over here because it does send it to the clipboard section. And when you paste it over here, it simply removes that from this particular cell. It cuts the value from this particular cell and pastes it somewhere else. So that was Control X. Then we have Control Y and Control Z. Control Y is redo and Control Z is undo. Control Y is redo, Control Z is undo. So basically, I'll just click on Control Z first and see it undoes my work. And I'll click on Control R. So it redoes my work basically. So redo and undo. Again, I click on Control Z. So it got selected, Control Z. And Control R. So this is how it does your work. So we have all these shortcuts from A to Z, which is used with Control key. So basically we have 23 shortcuts over here because we don't have shortcut keys for the three letters, which is J, M and Q. For the rest, we have all these shortcuts. So you may copy down these shortcuts for your simplicity in the future, for the future use. Thank you.